So, preparing for meditation, find a posture that is both comfortable and upright, energized yet relaxed. In meditation, it's very helpful to keep the spine upright, if we're able to do that. And so we begin by feeling the ground beneath us. Whether that be the cushion against our buttocks, or our feet on the floor. What's that experience of sitting? Where's the ground? How is that directly experienced? And then we can bring our attention to the upright axis of the spine. What is the direct experience there? In meditation, we establish the posture of the body, both upright and relaxed. So we can imagine sitting upright as if a fine string was lifting the crown of our head just a little bit. Feel what that uplift is like. And then let everything else in the body relax around that central axis. No need to hold tension anywhere. But this is an invitation to relax, not a command. Be aware of where there is tension. And if it doesn't, if it's not something we can relax, then simply send some goodwill to that tense area of the body. But no demands. As we settle into the body, we begin to experience the sensation of breathing. We pay attention to what does it feel like to breathe in? What does it feel like to breathe out? Where is that sensation prominent? Where is that sensation pleasant? It could be at the tips of the nostrils. Deeper into the palate. The throat. The chest, or the abdomen. Find a place that feels comfortable to put your attention when you're breathing. And let's spend about 2 minutes with that. Just experiencing the sensation of breathing. Being aware of that sensation of breathing. We can also be aware that the breath is more than just a sensation. There's an energetic quality that goes with the experience of breathing. The in-breath is energizing, enlivening, uplifting, inspiring. The out-breath is settling, calming, stilling. One can experience these qualities both in body and in mind. And it's unlike the sensations of breath, the uplifting quality of the in-breath can be felt throughout the entire body. And the settling quality of the out-breath can be felt throughout the entire body. This is a skillful means to bring a sense of wholeness to body and mind. Oftentimes in our lives, we become fragmented. If we have a lot of intellectual activity, we may be quite a divide between our head and the rest of our body. We live up there, and not quite sure what's down there. So, by tuning into the breath, we can help to heal that division and others. And we can also use the experience of the breathing to respond to the present conditions of body and mind. So, if your experience is one of dullness, drowsiness, lack of energy, then pay more attention to the in-breath as it goes in. Bring the attention to that energizing quality. Similarly, if the mind is restless or scattered, or the body is over-energized, bring more attention to the out-breath, that settling quality. And so we can practice like this for about another 7 minutes. So, being aware of the body, breathing in and out, noticing if the mind has wandered into the thoughts about the past, thoughts about the future, thoughts about ourselves, thoughts about other people. When it wanders, bring it back to the present experience of breathing. Paying attention to what the mind and body need now. If it's energizing, bring more attention to the in-breath. If the body needs settling, more attention to the out-breath. If the mind is very agitated, it might be helpful to recollect some of the words of the chanting that we just did. If the mind is quite settled, then one can begin to pay attention to the still points at the end of the in-breath and the end of the out-breath. When the breath is most subtle and stillness is most accessible. We can investigate, is it possible to really enjoy breathing? So we can practice like this for another 3 minutes. So, bringing the attention back to the experience of breathing. And as we near the end of this meditation session, it can be helpful to review our experience. What ways of breathing, what ways of sitting, what attitudes were helpful? What brightened the mind? What settled the mind? Just as the body remembers trauma, the body also remembers this peaceful state of, it's pleasurable, but it's not a pleasure because we've of the senses, not something we went out and did. Just learning, just being with the breath, right here, right now. This can be a refuge. And can we remember what it's like? Can we remember this place as we go through the week?